Hi, this is Mike Fox from Showpad, and I'm joined today by Carmina Coenen, who heads solutions engineering at Salesforce. At Showtime, you talked about the importance of AI for the sales and buying experiences. Could you share some of the insights?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so what I presented today was really about the value of artificial intelligence for business, indeed for anyone involved with customers. So everyone that has a passion for delighting the customer experiences, being it sales, service, or marketing. And we really looked at how you can use the power of that intelligence in your interactions and in your engagements with customers. This can be like recommendations that you get within the application that you're using just before you are preparing for going into a customer meeting. This can be insight that you get when you're looking at all your emails. So you get all your emails, but you don't have so much time, and those emails can be very long. Mm-hmm. And with artificial intelligence, it just grabs the content and it gives you recommendations, like just like you're used to on Amazon. When you're buying a book, you get these recommendations, and this is really the power and the value of artificial intelligence.
Sure, that's great. Is there other technologies that you see really impacting the sales experience?
There is a lot of technology impacting sales and customer experiences. It's not only about reading and digesting the data with all these algorithms. It can also be about recognizing pictures, for example. If customers and people are posting pictures on social media, which is super popular, then this can drive also interactions from a marketing point of view or even from a service point of view. And you have all the technology with the machines that are out there that can grab a lot of information. It can be from your home, where you have your thermostat. And when your thermostat is having an issue, what you want as a customer is to have the supplier of that thermostat to be on top of it. You don't want to wait to wake up in a cold room and then you start calling the technician. No, you want them to be alerted and you want them to be proactive with you. And that's what all is under the umbrella of the IoT, the Internet of Things, which really helps also be proactive and give that loyalty, that experience to customers.
Sure. So currently there's a lot of face-to-face interaction between the buyers and the sales folks. Mm-hmm. And there's some concerns that with AI coming, that's going to go away. What do you see with that, the face-to-face interaction?
Well, I think if you look at what these humanization of robots have delivered today, is they're still not there yet to have that face-to-face. You know, that's quite complex interaction that we can have with a customer. We can read faces. We can also change our strategy when we are in an interaction mode with a customer. So yes, artificial intelligence will give us insights that we don't have the time for. I still have a lot of unread emails. I still have a lot of work that I just can't do because my time is limited. Mm-hmm. And so I'm really happy that we get an artificial intelligence power that will make me smarter.
Right.
And then also give me power to connect better with my customers. Now, looking at the future and having that little bit of a concern, I would say this is just going to help me to become a better person in my career and to develop also in my career. I'm looking forward really to drones flying around, because they will not only help us in our professional life, but also in my personal life. Drones are now going to fly around in Switzerland. It's not far from here, mm-hmm. where they are going to pick up a blood sample from a hospital and bring it to a lab. You know, it used to be a taxi doing the work, and now it can be done in just minutes.
Sure.
And that is really what's driving the society. That's making the society better. That's making us as people better. And when we can see the benefits, when we feel the benefits in our consumer engagements, mm-hmm. we will expect them also in our professional engagement.
Oh, that's great. So we're really in a time of change, and it seems like change is just going to accelerate with these technologies that are really starting to show themselves now, and then the ones that are on the future. For sales and marketing people, you know, how do they embrace that change? What do they need to do to really make sure that they stay relevant and on top of their careers?
Mm-hmm. That's a tough question, and I think for every individual have to make up their own mind. But for me, It's by having that passion and having that willingness to be open-minded to the future. That's amazing. You know, when, like, in the beginning of the 90s, there were a lot of people helping you out when using an escalator.
Right.
These people, they're not there anymore. Mm-hmm. But they have found a different job. Mm-hmm. And now we are used to just having the escalator and the elevator, sorry, going up and down by just pushing a button. And we have to as well find our own button. Which button do we have to press? Which skill are we going to look for so that we can embrace that future? And there are a lot of opportunities. This is just something that you need to look for. What is close to your heart? What is your passion? Mm-hmm. So that you look for that second skill. You develop yourself. And as long as you have that eagerness to learn, then I think you will be fine.
Well, thank you very much, Carmina. I really appreciate talking to you.
No, thank you.